Welcome to episode 71 of our Family Travel Australia series. Ready to put the challenges of 2020 behind you and kickstart the year ahead? This week, we share details of the exact process we do to make the most of our year, including the free workbook we use every year to make our plans and set our goals. Plus, we look back at the highlights and squeeze the positivity out of 2020, including the best destination, best experience, best meal, best moment, and best campsite. From our family to yours, we wish you a happy, healthy, and hopeful 2021. There we go, 2021. Who else is excited about starting a new year?
I love this time of year. It is awesome. We always take time. We reflect on the year that was. Obviously, 2020 was incredibly challenging for everyone, everywhere. However, we had something really awesome happen for us at the very end of the year. We have a podcast. It's called Family Travel Australia. And it was awarded the number one podcast for travel and culture here in Australia.
Totally unexpected. Yes, we're feeling really grateful for that recognition. And if you don't know about our podcast, every Friday night at 8:30 p.m. it is released on every podcast platform and also through our website as well. And it's a bit of a blend, isn't it?
Yeah, look, I mean, it covers off our destination and travel experiences, the RV lifestyle, how we parent in 17 square meters, the challenges that come with it. It's a little bit more behind the scenes take on our life and our living, our experience, how we did it, why we do it, you know, and also future plans.
Bit of philosophy in there too.
Yeah, look, our own personal version of life's philosophy, which we love sharing. And the reason why we're telling you about our podcast is because we just did an episode on making the most of a year, which is a really wonderful program that we do every single year at this time of the year for over a decade now. There it is. And Rowan Dredge, who's the author, we don't have any affiliation, we've never met, although I'm sure at some point we would love to meet Rowan, because he has put together not only a fantastic program, but he has made it accessible for everyone because it is free.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable. It is an ebook or a workbook that you can download online. When we get through sharing with you just an overview and some of the key takeaways that we've got out of it, hopefully that it will inspire you to want to actually download this, we will give you the link to that. It's basically on our website, so you'll be able to access it there. So here it is. This is the best way, the best tool that we think that you can start 2021 off. Give yourself a roadmap. Give yourself an opportunity to set the year up for success. Here it is, making the most of a year.
Now, the program's broken down into a few key elements, and the first one is probably the most powerful question. We really love completing this. Okay, imagine it's the last day of the year and you are walking down the street and you bump into yourself. Who would you need to be? And what would you need to have done to be delighted to meet you?
I love this question. This is my favorite part of this program. It helps you focus on and give definition to who you want to be. You know, there's nothing better than having some clarity around your destination.
Oh, definitely.
Because then you can take intentional steps toward it. Which is very, very cool. After that, it really goes into eight key areas of your life and helps you to figure out your focus on those areas. And they include your career, money, health, family, romance, recreation, personal growth, and personal environment. This is set up as a wheel with those eight elements. And it helps you to focus on where you are at and then number yourself to where you want to be. Isn't that so cool?
It is, and there's something really powerful about the pen. So
writing it down, isn't that true?
It is so true. It gets you thinking about things that you maybe haven't thought about in a really long time. Well, actually, that's something that I've always wanted to do. Or, do you know, I used to love doing that and I haven't done it for a long time. So there is something magical that happens in this process.
I love it. Setting it up or thinking about it as giving yourself a blueprint mm-hmm. for the year ahead, it helps you to get more focus,
yeah.
gives you direction,
mm-hmm.
It helps you to take responsibility
mm.
for your life ahead, and it also gives you clarity. And I don't think there's anything more energizing than having clarity in your life.
Well, it's empowering too.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Yeah. Something else we love is that it really puts a focus on collaboration, which is something that Paul and I have always done, and helps turn the me into the we.
Yeah, look, there is nothing more powerful than being able to find someone to help or find a situation that you can add value to through your own life and your own application of a program like this.
Mm-hmm.
It really is a great way to set goals as well.
Yeah.
And we've got a favorite author, Napoleon Hill, who said that goals are dreams with a deadline.
Isn't that? Oh, it is so true.
And I think that this program, at its essence, is that it's helping you to define your dreams and then focus on the steps required to put a deadline in place, actions in place to make those dreams a reality.
Yep, perfect. And yeah. after 2020, now is the perfect time to be doing
yes.
something like this, to set up 2021, walk in with that positive mindset, and set yourself up for a really fantastic year.
Attack the year with a good attitude and mm-hmm. an open heart, you know, and an open mind for betterment. We have got this as a direct download on our website, all the W's, thefeelgoodfamily.com.au. It is free. All that it really requires and costs is your time, your
yep.
dedication, a committed window of time to actually put this action into place.
Do it.
Yeah, all the best. Go for it. Do it for yourself. Do it for your family. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and then we're going to come back and share the highlights for us from 2020. We wanted to really focus on the positive outcomes that we've had through that time, and then share what we think we've got coming up for 2021. Okay, 2020 was jam-packed with some highlights. Here they are, your number one location last year.
Definitely Stanley in Tasmania, on the northwest, such an epically beautiful spot with that core of the ancient volcano that juts out into the ocean. I just loved our time there. The wildlife was spectacular, getting to go out and see the seals.
The dolphins,
yes, watching those penguins come up on the beach at night time, experiencing the nut, getting to go up on the chairlift and walk around the top of the core of the volcano was spectacular. Driving on the beach was amazing.
I think it really captures what you hope your experience in Tasmania would be like in one place.
Yeah. It was a great starting destination for our trip around Tasmania.
Yeah, perfect.
What about you? What was your favourite?
Okay, I'm going to bring it back to Queensland, and it is Pumpkin Island.
Oh, good choice.
Part of the Keppel group of islands off the Capricorn Coast. This 6-acre island is a world leader for environmental ecotourism. It is the only hotel in Australasia to be awarded the world's most sustainable hotel. It's completely powered by the wind and the sun. There's 7 different beach cottage accommodation options, so you feel like you're basically on your own little island escape. The water, the colour of the water.
Spectacular.
And again, that abundance of wildlife as it is surrounded by green zone, and it's located on the southern end of the Great Barrier Reef. So what a world-class destination.
Yeah, the perfect chilled beach island escape.
Yeah, absolutely. And whether you're a family like us, or a young couple, or even a larger group, I mean, you can hire the entire island as your getaway destination, maybe for a wedding.
We'll have to do that, I think.
Renew our vows.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Next one, your number one meal for 2020.
Gosh, well, we had a lot of good ones.
My Weber cooking.
Sorry, husband. No, the standout for me was on South Stradbroke Island at Tippler's Licensed Cafe just recently during our stay over there. We had the most incredible seafood lunch in that environment, which is right on the waterside, on the island. Again, a really relaxed, chilled vibe, but with breathtaking views and such easy access from the Gold Coast as well. You can see why it's a favourite with the Gold Coast locals.
Yeah, I love that you have got the calm waters of the broad water on one side and then just a short 10-minute walk through that naive Australian bushland, all the wallabies bouncing around, and then you're on the Pacific Ocean side with that wonderful surf beach. It is absolutely a hidden gem of the Gold Coast. And I can't wait to go back.
Oh, and world-class food. Yeah.
All right, my number one meal, I'm going to take you back to Tassie, would be on Bruny Island at Hotel Bruny.
Yes.
Okay, this again was another seafood sensation. It was a platter for two. I think it was turned into a platter for one. It was absolutely, again, about not only the food and the meal experience, but the environment.
That view.
Yeah, and it is the number one place on Bruny Island to take in that incredible sunset across mainland Tasmania. Absolutely stunning. A place that I hope we will revisit again.
Oh, how good was Bruny Island?
Yeah, actually, it doesn't matter where you go on Bruny Island, whether you're down deep in the south part of the island to the lighthouse and that experience, or coming up through the neck.
Well, we stayed, we free camped.
Yeah, look, it's a highlight for many reasons.
Yeah, we love you, Tassie.
All right, your number one experience for 2020.
I think we're stuck in Tasmania because we are on the Tasman Peninsula. Hands down, without a doubt for me, is the Pennicott's Wilderness Cruise that we did out of Port Arthur. Talk about an amazing half-day experience that combines adventure, adrenaline, wildlife, epic landscapes. Oh my goodness.
I mean, it's the tallest sea cliffs in the southern hemisphere. Mm-hmm. And you know, you're looking up 300 feet.
Unbelievable.
Amazing. And do you know what else was the highlight? Was the star.
Yeah.
And the narration, the knowledge, the sharing of the flora and fauna, and again in that epic landscape that Tasmania offers. It was truly a breathtaking experience.
And family friendly as well, Jasper. Loved that.
It's a great blend of enough adventure to feel heart pounding at moments, but in the safety and security of this luxurious purpose-built vessel.
Yeah, amazing, without a doubt.
Do you know, I would have chosen that as my number one as well.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, so what are you going to choose?
So snap. My actual number one would have to be back here in Queensland, way out west, red dirt tours with Vicky.
What a contrast too between the Pennicott's in Tassie and out there in Winton in outback Queensland.
Look, again, it quite often comes down to whoever the lead guide is on these tours or these experiences, and Vicky was remarkable. She was able to deliver a constant narration of the landscape, the history, the culture. Her storytelling was so good and put in layman's terms so that you could easily digest it and stay engaged for a full day's tour. We were able to get access to private property that you otherwise, without this red dirt tour, wouldn't have been able to. Again, it opened up new vistas and new landscapes, and the footage from the drone was just breathtaking. We then headed out, I think 110 kilometres on this corrugated red dirt road to the Dinosaur Stampede. Now, this is a national monument. I mean, how they found this place still blows my mind. But what an incredible experience to go out and see fossilised dinosaur stampede from 95 million years ago.
Yeah.
Blows my mind.
And something that Jasper still talks about is Winton and the dinosaur experience. So definitely pop that one on your list if you are headed to Outback Queensland this year.
Yeah, incredible experience. The other part that Vicky also offers is the rangelands. Again, a private property, but with a landscape like a movie set. I don't know how else to explain it. It is incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible. All right, what was your number one moment for 2020?
Yeah, well, I am taking you back to Tassie, and I do have a bit of a love affair with Tasmania. It's the feeling that I had when we actually got off the Spirit of Tasmania. We didn't make too many plans, and we got lots of great advice from friends who had been to Tassie before that said to us, don't overbook, don't lock in too much. You'll get to meet so many amazing locals who will give you great tips on where to go and where to stay and what to do and see. And so as we rolled off the boat, the only thing we knew we were going to do was go in an anti-clockwise direction. And we found a wonderful little strawberry farm that we stopped, had breakfast, pulled out the map, made some plans. It was cold.
What a great start to our adventure there.
It was amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So all of those feelings and, you know, the dream of getting back to Tassie had been a long one. So to actually finally be there, that I think was my highlight moment.
We love Tassie. Have we ever told you that?
What about you? What was your moment?
I love Queensland, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It seems to be like a Queensland versus Tasmania state off.
Look, my number one moment is still having that in the moment presence with Jasper, you know, and without getting emotional about this, but being a dad and working back when we were making this plan, and for the whole outcome and the whole goal for me was about having more time together as a family. So then catching myself in that moment and those moments now, it could be anything. It could be him just laying, you know, out here on the mat, or playing with his train set, or, you know, yelling out, Dad, can we do this? But actually being present and witness to him growing up is the biggest gift out of this. And if you're out there and you're watching this and you're dreaming about this, there is nothing better as a motivator than looking to be able to spend more time with your family.
Yeah.
Especially your kids at this age. So. Yeah, so there you go. So that's me.
Beautiful.
All right. What was your number one campsite?
Oh, again, we've stayed at lots of beautiful places, but surprise, surprise, the highlight for me was in Tasmania, in the Huon Valley, at the beautiful Huonville Caravan Park, which was not a caravan park at all. It was this epically beautiful, lush green grass, acres upon acres upon acres to choose from. And the site that we picked backed onto that crystal clear, extremely icy cold river that flowed through. And we camped next to some beautiful people who we now call very good friends, who incidentally put us up in their driveway for the 4.5 months that we were in lockdown in Tasmania. So lots of good memories from that campsite.
All right, for me, number one campsite is a place back here in Queensland, McBrides Ball, just west of Barkie, Bacolden, on our way out to Winton. And we spent a couple of nights here. The owner operator was a guy of a sheep station. His name's David. And I said to him, oh, look, are we fairly spread out, or how's it set up? And he said, look, you, the closest camper to you is 4 kilometers away. It's true.
It was amazing.
And you come through this really what was like a dust bowl, you know.
Sheep paddocks.
Yeah, and just barren land. And then finally come to almost like a mirage where there's a huge windmill, some solar panels, and they are pumping water out of the artesian basin. And it is at about, I don't know, 70 or 80 degrees Celsius. You actually have to, when you run the massive bath, let it sit for over an hour just so that it can cool down. And then Jasper and I, a bit of skinny dipping,
mm-hmm.
and watched that sunset, having this experience at McBride's really summed up the picture that I was dreaming about for all those years when I was really thinking what this lifestyle would look and feel like. It captured that perfectly.
Yeah, it was a definite aha moment, wasn't it?
Yeah, look, and we'll put all the details for that particular location below as well, in the description. And if you can book yourself some time out in a place where you are completely alone, the only real thing that you've got as company are 5 billion stars. I mean, it is incredible. So there you go, 2020 and our highlights.
It was Tassie, Queensland, wasn't it?
Look, it was, but a really great thing to do is to reflect, and if you haven't got something to celebrate, look at the things that you can be thankful for.
Great point.
And have an attitude of gratitude, and certainly a great way to bounce yourself and your energy and your enthusiasm into 2021.
Awesome.
All right, now if you do love what we do and you haven't already, subscribe to our YouTube channel, hit the notification bell, give us your support, and we are excited and thrilled that you're on the journey with us and that we can bring you some amazing content for 2021.
Season 4 announcement coming up soon, so stay tuned for that as well.
All right, and remember just to keep dreaming big and look after yourself and look after your family.
And happy trails.
Thanks for watching. Please do like, subscribe, and share our channel. And if you'd like more information on full-time RV travel and living, visit our website, thefeelgoodfamily.com.au. There you'll find loads of free resources, our weekly podcast, caravan cooking recipes, our monthly Go RV magazine articles, and much more. We look forward to seeing you next week. Take care of yourself and your family, and happy trails. Absolutely. And in doing this, we also reflect on the year that was, which gets me to what we're here to talk about today. 2020 for us was an amazing year. And I don't really know what I'm saying, so can we do it again? Yeah.